heading out Moreton Bay, chasing a couple shallow water snapper, using as light as possible today. Running some fresh squid and some live herring. We're just gonna go jig them up, put an anchor down and see how we go for the arvo. So we're just coming along to the normal area where we jig bait. Got a bit of a show there. I think the key thing in fishing in the bay is fresh or live bait. And if you don't have it, then you've got not much of a chance. There's a couple. Never mind the reel, she's a bit clunked out, but I tell you what, she's had a bit of a beating in her day. There's a couple. And that is what we're chasing. Big live herring, fresh as they come. I'll tell you what, big snapper, I did not mind them. I'll show you how they go in probably about an hour's time, eh? So I'm just gonna run you through how I fish with snapper in the bay in a bit deeper water. So I'll get a good maybe meter and a half of trace. I'm just running 50 pound. I'm just gonna do a swivel, just your standard long snell onto a swivel with a running ball sinker on the top of your swivel. So I'll just tie this snell up. I just do the original snell. I always run a circle on the bottom. It's a size, I think, 7 Gamigatsu. That's always what I go to for snapper, especially like live baiting. If I'm not live baiting, I'm using the Elcat Gangs, which works a treat, especially when you're offshore. And I'll run size 7 or size 6, bit smaller, just a straight hook on top. I find you always end up catching bigger snapper on that bottom hook. I'll just spread them apart for the size of your livey. So, I mean, it's probably about 100 mil sort of size, one in the head and one in the tail. Always just duck them under the chin in the liveys, which I'll show you in a sec. Some people go through the back of the head, but always just go through underneath the chin. It seems to hold a bit better. So I'll just get the end of that and get a swivel on it. It's just a 40 or 50 pound Black Magic swivel, nothing special. No overhang, my number one hate. Cut your overhang off. Always gets twisted up in your overhang. Otherwise, if you've got current or whatnot, you always pull up and it's twisted around your overhang. So always cut that off. And I'm just gonna run super light, just a one ball, little one ball sinker, just straight on there. And one thing that I have forgotten is my glow tube. A bit of glow tube. Always use that. All it does is protects your knot. So just cut a tiny bit of that, slip that on. So you got your sinker, slip that on. And then straight onto your swivel. So then you have a running ball sinker onto your glow tube, which hits the top of your swivel, down to a nice looking snell. And that's as simple as it is. Coming up on the spot here, 17 meters. There's a bit of bait on it, a couple fish hanging off it. Let's see if they're biting. Can only hope, especially in the bay. It's a bit hit and miss sometimes, but you can see a couple good arches hugging the bottom here. livey from earlier. Wee. Slippery. Nice herring. He's going straight on my hook. Righto, I go one in the tail. You sort of can measure them up if you're not exactly familiar. I go one in the tail. Let's pull a few scales off. One in the tail. And then I go one up under the lip to the top of his nose. And there you have it. And he is going straight down. And let's hope there's a snapper down there. Let's keep feeding line out. Just doing a little drift. Good day out here, I can tell you that much. For nothing. I won't charge you anything to tell you that. The disappointing part is when you pull it up and the hook that I never doubt fails.
You're on the verge of a stalling right there.
Yeah, we are. I'm gonna get him back. This is a big snapper. Oh yeah. So I just put on a single circle. I thought we'd just change it up a bit. Instead of the snell.
This one might be getting touched here too.
Yeah, Just worry about this one, Jai, for a sec.
Do we need a nap? Come on, Sam.
John Dim, this is a big dewy. Oh, yes. Quality dewy.
Jesus!
Woo!
Damn. That's not a bad looking dewy. Yeah, bros.
Dewy. Moreton Bay dewy. He's probably 12 kilo, I reckon. 10, 12 kilo. What is he on the measure? Oh, he's well. He's probably a meter and five. There's 90. He's got a meter over a meter. Good fish. This feels more like a snapper, Joy.
I seen the head shakes on the rod there, mate. It's looking good.
Just feeling a bit better.
Just been burling up on the pillies, keeping a steady stream of burly going, and the livey's out the back.
Got that dewy earlier, just out the back. So we just wait for that sun to completely go down. I'll just sit here for another hour or two. I think it's paid off. Oh, I just dropped him.
Right at the bow.
Wow. That's not good. Decky doing the decky duties.
Chasing a snapper in the bay. Not bad.
Local nobby. Launching from Cleveland Harbour. It is 3:34. Tide is running in. 7:30 high. Perfect for shallow water snapper in Moreton Bay. 6:30 snapper.
Yep.
Righto, let's go. Big nobby. Check the drag. Are you sure it's good? What pound leader you got on? Reuben is on a nice fish. I'm calling big nobby. I think the key is to when you're float lining in the bay, it's just light as possible. And by that I mean near no weight. Or if it is weight, it's only a zero ball or, you know, a one ball. What do we got? Have we got any colour?
Oh yeah, it's a big knobby too.
Oh man, that's huge.
That is a big knobby down there. Get him up, Ruben. Get him up.
Don't panic. Get him up. What do you reckon, eh? Big bay snapper.
Oh, geez.
Yeah, boy.
Yeah.
Yes, Ruben.
That is huge.
Yes, Ruben. That is a nice bay snapper.
Hold him up for the camera, boy.
Oh,
as I was saying, light as possible, two bull sinkers, snell rig.
Brother, that's huge.
Hold him up.
That's
will
my
you?
PB, eh? Sure.
Ruben has got it.
Now, that is what we do in wintertime, ladies and gentlemen.
No, Mrs. Fishing.